Thanks for your company this morning. Anguish is turning to anger in the wake of the floodwaters that rushed through Maribyrnong, and this is why. A flood wall erected around Flemington Racecourse, protecting the track, but making the situation for neighbouring residents worse.
Well, one local who's been speaking out is former councillor and current Green Senator Janet Rice, who joins us now. Senator, thanks for your time this morning. You were pretty vocal over the weekend about this. How confident are you that it was actually the wall that's made the floodwaters worse?
Look, you can't know, and I've heard this morning that Melbourne Water are going to be doing an analysis to determine sort of their assessment as to whether the flood wall had an impact on how bad the flooding was. But you can see from those photos, if you look at the proportion of the floodplain that has been walled off, the water that would have flowed over the racecourse, it's got to go somewhere else. And we've also known that the residents in Maribyrnong upstream said that the flood rose really quickly. So, you know, it seems pretty obvious to me. It seems that right back in before 2007, when the wall was built, when I was on council, and all three local councils, I was on Maribyrnong Council, the City of Melbourne and the City of Moonee Valley, all campaigned against this wall because they said it was inappropriate to be walling off such a large proportion of the floodplain because of these sort of circumstances, that essentially if you wall off or build on parts of the floodplain, it makes the flooding worse elsewhere.
Okay, so you had three councils at the time all say, we think this is a bad idea. Locals were upset about it. We also had Bill Shorten on the show. He's the local member there. He said he was against it. If that's the case, why did it ever go ahead?
Well, it's the power of the racing industry and the power of the gambling industry in the state of Victoria. That's why it went ahead. And the Labor government at the time, it was the BRACS government, they made the decision for the wall to go ahead. And so we just didn't have a say, even though as councils we should have been the planning authorities. It's the councils that have got to pick up the, you know, clean up the mess afterwards.
I'm not sure what you're saying. Are you saying that it was greased through or something? Because a business has a right to, I guess, protect itself, and we know what's coming up there in just a couple of weeks' time with the Melbourne Cup, but are you saying that things weren't done right?
Look, other people don't get the right to wall off parts of the floodplain. Other property developers who own land on the floodplain don't get the right to build on it because the good planning says if you're on the floodplain, it's where the water's got to go when you've got flooding events like this. And so there was really good evidence that, you know, this is a really important part of the floodplain. It's why the racecourse was there, because it's the sort of land use that can cope with floods, like other parkland. You know, I've been down in the parkland on my side of the river over the weekend, and it was flooded on Friday, and it's looking pretty good on Sunday. So that they can cope with floods. But the racecourse decided that it was too special, that and it put its case to the state government, and for whatever reason, and what certainly wasn't on the basis of good planning advice, they got approval to build their wall.
All right. Well, as you said, there's going to be an inquiry, so hopefully we get a few more of those answers in the months ahead. Janet, really appreciate your time. Thank you.
Just have a look at that photo once more, if we can. And look, it does kind of make sense that the wall has done its job in protecting the track from the water. Now, whether or not the other parts of the community have been flooded as a direct result of that is going to be debated and discussed no end. But if you're one of those houses that's been inundated by floodwaters, you're filthy. The pressure hoses, mops, rakes and gumboots out in Melbourne today as thousands pitch in to help the clean-up in Maribyrnong.
Maribyrnong Mayor Anthony Tran joins us now. Really appreciate your time this morning, Mayor. We saw the big clean-up efforts underway over the weekend, but it's really testing your community, this one, isn't it?
Morning, Kyle. Morning, Anthony. Yeah, look, it's been a big challenge, but honestly, the community have come together in one of our most difficult times, and so have the SES. They've come to our assistance and VicPo, and just hats off to everyone that's been involved in the clean-up process.
How much damage is there?
I can't give you that answer in numbers, but just by looking at it, there's been a fair few. Just right behind me, we've got one of our residents that have emptied out what looks to be their garage, and there is just a boatload of hard waste that we need to collect and to help them remove. Mm.
Just looking at that behind you there, Anthony, I mean, and that is a scene you're seeing outside of so many houses in that suburb there. What have people been telling you over the weekend and how they're feeling?
Look, the messages are so mixed. It's a mixture of anger, a mixture of fear of what could happen next, but also some of the messages have been just messages of encouragement for a lot of the neighbours, which is, for me, a big, big up. And questions of what further support will come for each of our residents.
There's also a whole lot of anger over the Flemington Wall, right? How are you addressing that?
Yeah, Carl, look, at this stage in time, for the city of Maribyrnong, for me especially, my priority is really getting our residents back home. Because when I spoke to those residents, they couldn't care much about that wall. All they cared about was what was going on inside their homes. The mementos, the family photos, the different items you just cannot replace. For them, that's what they cared about. For them, we're trying to get them home, especially to get them home so they can start the clean-up job as well.
Yeah.
See, a lot of them, what you're talking about there, a lot of them feel that their homes perhaps wouldn't have flooded had this water not been redirected from the floodplains into their homes. Are you not hearing that from people on the ground?
I've heard a lot of messages as to what could have happened and what would have happened, but the fact is we're here now, honestly, and whether those flood walls are up or down, what happened after catchment was important as well. And that modelling that we did with the SES was crucial for us to get the preparation done and to do it in a way that we needed to get done.
I guess you don't want it to happen again, though. Is it something that you will be looking at in the fullness of time?
Yeah, look, we'll be working alongside state government to see what we can do to prevent further flooding in our local community, of course. I mean, every local representative will be saying the same words because it's true. We do need to do we need to do more to protect our community from any natural disasters, but in this case, flooding.
I did hear too, you've got hydrology experts saying that a dam in the area could potentially have saved hundreds of homes. I know it was proposed and rejected back in 2006. Is that something should now be looked at?
Yeah, look, I'm not too sure what that scoping was back then. Obviously, in 2006, I was 7 years old back then. So for us, if it was to be looked at, it'd be based on the briefings that we get from officers and recommendations, and obviously that comes from the experts as well. So once we get that briefing, and if we get those notes, then we can finally have a discussion about it. But until then, there's not much to say.
All right, more rain predicted too, Mayor. That's not fantastic news, is it? How's everyone psychologically going?
Yeah, look, a little bit of drizzle would help us clear these roads off, but any more torrential rain and I think we'd be in a bit more strife. But we're keeping our hopes up, our spirits up. I mean, the last few days have been quite sunny, and if it remains that way, fingers crossed it does, then we're looking all right.
Are you the youngest mayor in Australia?
Oh, I'm not going to make any claims, but I'd like to think so.
At 23 years of age, aren't we? You're young to be taking on something so significant like this, but all the very best of it. They'll need all that energy there. We appreciate you being on.
It's impressive.
Welcome back. Yeah. Victorians continue to battle rising floodwaters this morning, with thousands more homes set to be impacted by the disaster. Among those already damaged are those living along the Maribyrnong River, with residents now demanding answers over whether the controversial construction of a flood wall around Flemington Racecourse made flooding worse.
Let's get today's take on this with 9 Honey's Shelley Horton and 2GB's Ben Fordham. Shelley, I'll go to you first, though. Maribyrnong residents have argued against this construction. They protested it way back in 2007 because they feared it would direct floodwaters straight into their homes. I think their fears have now sort of happened. What do you think?
Oh, look, you just have to look at the aerial photos to see the impact that it has had. And those people, they must be heartbroken and yet so vindicated and furious that something has to be done. I mean, the council has approved it, so the council is responsible. But I'm not a massive horse racing fan. I understand the income it brings into the community. So I would say, as an olive leaf or an olive branch, I would say that maybe Flemington Racecourse needs to donate money to those homes that have been affected just to stop the war between the haves and the have-nots.
Well, at the very least, it needs to be investigated, right, Ben?
Yeah, well, I really feel for Shane Truen, who all those years ago, he's one of the local residents, said, I'm going to fight this thing tooth and nail until I die. Mm. He sadly lost his life 3 years ago. His wife, Jane, has quoted him in the last 24, 48 hours saying, Shane always said that despite all of the energy that I've got in my system to beat the system, they're bigger than me, I'm never going to defeat them. And as Shelley said, the aerial images really paint a million words in this case, because you can see. Have a look at it.
Yep.
There's Flemington Racecourse. It's protected. It's dry. Mm-hmm. Around the outskirts.
And the homes are copping it.
It ended up being every home for itself.
Yeah, I feel for that family and all the residents there too.